So why this is important, so Council Patrick commissioned this piece of work in response to the good evidence that shows that by working with local people, organisations can get better outcomes for local people and can achieve greater value for money for the public purse. And I think most significantly you'll see that when we conducted our resident survey in 2015, over half of our local residents did not feel that they could influence the decisions affecting their areas.
So can we turn the lights off? It's been doing the six slides. We just
thank you. £1 spent on these projects, we would get a £2.68 return. Now, again, that would vary depending on the project. So in some of the projects, that might increase to £8 per pound spent. And finally, there were some recommendations from that report in terms of continuing to ensure we're evaluating the projects, being clear on when we actually look to sustain those projects centrally. Thanks, Caroline. And just for your benefit, because it was some of the feedback I'd had from councillors around the table, just to give you an indication of how that looks. I know this text is very small, but we'll circle it so you can have a look. You can see how that expenditure pans out across each of the constituencies and what that looks like. Thanks, Caroline. And finally, the final piece of work, and really, I suppose, the most interesting piece of work, was the work that we did talking to a range of people, and that was through individual interviews with people, focus groups, surveys, workshops. We used a range of methodologies to undertake this. And it's quite a huge piece of work, as you can imagine, but this summarises some of the key findings from that. So you all around the table, and probably people in the audience, won't be surprised to hear that, you know, there was a very strong consensus that when communities worked with organisations, it was highly valued and felt to be much more effective. And some of the particular examples cited there were some of the projects that are ongoing across Wirral. So some of these people will be familiar with. So the Improving Life Chances projects that are operating in Birkenhead and Rockbury and Seacombe, Eastern Connects, Litter Picks, Door Knocks, those kind of activities were seen to be particularly useful for engaging with communities in terms of getting action delivered, but also providing an opportunity to talk to residents. Again, you won't be surprised, and I'm saying that as somebody born and bred in Wirral, our communities are very diverse and have varying assets, needs and interests. So there was a strong sense that, again, one size would not fit all. But on the flip side, I think there was a consensus view that there were opportunities for having discussions with local residents through the existing community networks and engagement through action instead of formalised meetings. So you can see here that for a large number of the respondents across those range of people that we spoke to, the formal committee setting was not considered to be the right forum for engaging with local people for a variety of reasons. The small grant and seed funding was reported particularly by local communities as enabling that action to take place. So letting people be able to get on with doing stuff. So give us some money, we can get a skin, we can buy some equipment for litter picks, it actually makes things happen. And similarly, support for community groups to leverage more money in from external funders or skills for community organising, and also basic things like information about what's happening within your local area so you can get involved, were all things highlighted as ways to facilitate resident action. It's important to note that I think particularly councillors recognise the role that the constituency officers have provided in unblocking issues or concerns from local residents and getting speedier resolutions. Community stakeholders suggested that there was probably a role for community builders, so connecting local groups better together. And finally, and I think I should point out that we took this piece of work was conducted last summer, so at the time there was a kind of message coming back, particularly from our community insights. I'm sure you won't be surprised necessarily to hear that, but there was some apathy regarding the political system, and I think that suggested that there was some strain between the relationship between organisations and local people. Okay, so in terms of next steps, obviously we wanted to reflect what we'd heard back to all the committees and just to test that out, and so that's happening this month. Council Patrick is proposing to take a report to Cabinet reflecting the findings from this work and his proposals for moving forward in the new municipal year. And we are obviously continuing to work with the Wirral Partnership to look at how we deliver the Wirral Plan with our communities and using some of this work and others to drive that forward. Okay, thanks for listening.
Thank you very much.